Hello and welcome back. This is Susheta Sengupta Roy from Swami Vivekananda Institute of Modern Science, Department of Media Science. So today we'll be discussing about freedom of speech. Well, this is obviously a part of the media laws under the syllabus of BSc as well as MSc. So it comes under BMS 2002 and as well as in, if it is law and MSc paper, it is MMC 2004. So basically, we are talking about the law portion. And when we talk about law, what is to be done and what is not to be done? What is to be done is legal. What is not to be done is illegal. That's how we understand law. So when we talk about what is legal, so what are the do's? And what is illegal, that means what are the don'ts? So the first thing when we talk about media and when we talk about the press, the first thing which comes to our mind, like, is press free? Or if it is, if we are talking about freedom, if press cannot speak or cannot write or cannot show what exactly is happening in the society, and it has to be, you know, without the journalists or the press person's his or her own viewpoint, it's absolutely the truth. So basically the work of a journalist is to bring the truth from the public to the public, and wherein there will not be any, you know, you cannot put any, you know, no additions and no subtractions, excepting if it is communal or if it is somewhere, it is supporting sedition or any type of riot. So that should always be avoided. Or if it is a lot of violence and which is like, no, which is not for a regular public to see or to understand. So let us understand what exactly is freedom of speech. So here we will understand what is freedom of press in India. Now, as I told you, this will come under your syllabus for graduate students. BSc Media Science will be BMS 2002, which is in the second semester. And for Masters, which is MSc in Media Science, that will come under in the first semester, that is MMC 104. So, here will be understanding, as I told you, like, the press has to be free. And what is the freedom of press in India? So, that's what we are trying to, you know, understand now. Now, so this is the abstract. What is the abstract of? So, freedom of expression. So, freedom of speech. So, you know, it's like how you express yourself. Are you being able to express yourself in a democratic way? So, like, whatever you want, you can speak out. But then, obviously, there has to be the cause and cons or the do's and don'ts. What you can speak and what you should not be doing it. So, it's like freedom of expression has always been emphasized as an essential basis for the democratic functioning of a society. So, freedom of press has remained an issue that has led to endless numbers of debates across the democratic world in the past few decades. So the democratic credentials of a state are judged today by the extent of the freedom of press enjoyed by that state. So the press provides comprehensive and objective information of all aspects of the country's social, political, economic and cultural life. So the answer for the question whether the press has absolute freedom under Article 19 of the Indian Constitution, so that is like the Constitution of India, is to express whatever seems right to it, has mixed views in the research. So the press in the fourth press is basically considered as the fourth pillar of the Constitution, and hence it is considered as the most important organization in the society. The object of the paper is to analyze whether the press has got real freedom of study or the freedom of press in India is not relevant. So how do we, you know, what is the introduction to it? So like the free press is vital and basic for the, you know, viable working of vote-based system. So the free press has likewise been depicted as the oxygen of vote-based system. So what is vote-based system? That's our democracy. That's what we call our democracy. So in our democracy, obviously, press has to be free to talk what they exactly should talk about, what people should know. So the history of freedom of press is the how like it weighs back. So what is the way back of it? the beginning of the battle with the expectation of the complementary discourse in India go back to 18th century British India. The historical background of the flexibility of press in India is in this invisible and basically from the historical backdrop of the Patriot development. So the Patriot development of India, free India, was battled with suppression of the right to speak freely and basically the articulation through a progression or enactment done for smoothing the likelihood of a merged, you know, outery against frontiers oppression. So the press basically in 1951, the prelude of the press was done. And then the Press Board Act in 1965, following the British point of reference, a press board was considered in 1996 under the Press Chamber of Act in 1965. So which was authorized to basically actually the suggestion to the press constitution. So what is the hypothesis of it? So the alternative is press is free to do whatever seems right to it. And what should I be? Is press is not free whether it seems right or not. Opportunity of press are basically three fundamental components. What are the three components? One, freedom of access to all wellsprings of data. Two, freedom of distribution. And three, opportunity. Obviously, the opportunity part. So the opportunity of press is what? There are numerous occurrences where opportunity of press has been stifled by the governing body. In Sakal paper versus Association of India, the everyday daily paper, cost of and a page arranged 1960, which settled the quantity of pages and size which a daily paper could distribute at a cost, was held to be violate of flexibility of press and not sensible confinement of under the Article 19 subsection 2. So also in Bennett versus Association of India, the legitimacy of the newsprint control order, which settled the most extreme number of pages, was struck around the count holding it to be. So violate of arrangement of Article 19 subsection 1 and subsection A, so, and not be sensible limitations under Article 19 subsection 2. So the court additionally dismissed the request of the legislature that would be held the little daily paper. So it's basically the confinement of freedom of press in India. So how does this growth, like the confinement has to grow? So how does it grow? So the flexibility of press comes extremely close to disclosure and articulation. So in majority rule government, opportunity of press is exceeding fundamental as the press goes about as a guard dog on the three organs of the vote-based system and lawmaking body and official and legal. So be it, it may, the flexibility of press isn't outright in nature, the liability of specific confinement, which is said to be in Article 19, Subsection 2 of the Constitution. So what the next is? The accompanying of the ground of confinement set down in Article 19, Subsection 2. So what are those? The sovereignty and integrity of India as per the Constitution of India, security of the state, friendly relations with foreign states, public order, decency or morality, and contempt of court. So these are the points which accompany. So what are the grounds of public order or friendly relation with the foreign state? The ground of public order or friendly relationship was added by Constitution, the First Amendment 1, which is in 1951. So while the ground of sovereignty and integrity in India was added by the Constitution on the Sixth Amendment, which was done in 1963. So the current scenario, the current scenario of press and its achievement, it has been stopped before the press was viewed on one of the mysteries of a vote-based system. So what is it? It's delighted in the residents, yet it's numerous case where the press needs to confront troubles also. In outgoing past, in suppose you must be knowing about the Tehelka case. The entryway of Tehelka.com was compelled. It was basically a huge political massacre. So compelled to close down totally, and its writers were persistently pestered as the communists uncovered the trick in the protection service, including the ex-resistance faculty and focal government pastors. So this has been same in innumerable cases from time to time. So when we talk about the freedom of press, it is the constitutional perspective. So the preference of Indian constitution rotates to secure everyone from the natives of India. So like the freedom of thought, articulation and conviction. So from this is basically based on Article 19, subsection 1, wherever you feel like that the extension of the privilege incurred by the article, or it might be influenced the task of the current law, or it may be, you know, it has to be to keep the state from making any law. So as far as, you know, all things considered, law, it is forced a sensible limitations in the activity of the privilege given by the, you know, said subprovision in the light of the legitimate concern for power and respectively of India. So the security of the state, agreeable relations with outside states, open request, fairness or profound quality, or in connection to hatred of court, maligning or induction to an offense, the media gets its right from the privilege to the right to speak freely and articulation accessible to the residents. So along these lines, the media has similar rights, no more or no less, a person to encompass, distribute, flow or communicate. It has to communicate, they have to. The press should be responsible. When we have you, when you know it, everything, when rights comes with responsibilities. If you have the right, you have to abide by the responsibility. Similarly, the press, if they have the right to speak the right thing or the and right to speak that this is wrong, they should always be guided with responsibilities. What are their responsibilities? So in fact, in spite of the fact that the press has assumed huge parts for open welfare, however, an occasion in act, you know, flippancy, for example, the electronic media build up the Abhi Aishwarya, you know, the Abhishek Bachchan and Aishwarya Rai when they were wedded. So, like, obviously, you can understand Aishwarya Rai was Westworld and Abhishek Bachchan, obviously, son of Amitabh Bachchan, the great. So, like, obviously, their wedding was, you know, it became a critical news and were dismissed. So, in proof, so, you know, Sharawal case, when Professor Sharawal was slaughtered by AVP activists, there were various news channels and daily papers, reporters were available and they had confirmation of the murder. However, the media acted unreliably and the police called it a simple situation. As of late, when Mumbai was under a fair risk, like that, the like 26/11, by the terrorist attack, so the media acted untrustworthy by broadcasting live and the long 60-hour task, the black tornado by the security powers to battle the assault at the Taj Mahal castle or the Nirman house. So it was it is said to be the Bombay blast or the Bombay terrorism. So is a Mumbai terrorism. So this was a standout amongst the most condemnable act, which demonstrates the terrible side of press. So press has to be really, really, you know, they have to be responsible. So, you know, you cannot say like we are done with. So thank you so much. So obviously we can understand that freedom of press is it's a right or it's a lot of power, but power comes up with lot of responsibilities. You have rights as per the Article 19 of the Indian Constitution. You have right to speak the right thing, you have right to speak the you have to, you know, bring the right thing or the truth in front of the public, but please make sure it comes with a lot of responsibilities, that one wrong message or one wrong news to the mass can really get into a major hassle for the whole society. So we have a major responsibility towards our country, towards our state, and towards our fraternity, which is journalism. Thank you, and I'll be back with another legal note or a legal tutorial for my next class. Thank you so much.